It owes me a considerable amount of money. Money that he would have been able to pay me back if you hadn't walked away from that fight last night.
So you know I'm his father, then?
I didn't. Not at first. But yes. I didn't think it mattered. These matters are completely separate in my mind.
Well, not mine.
What are you saying?
Reno's a friend of mine.
That's nonsense. Reno Paulsen doesn't have any friends.
I'm his friend.
Oh, I see. Quite a dilemma. Well, tell you what, Mr. Brückner. I always pay my debts. I owe you a favor. I'm going to hold up my end of the bargain.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that.
Then hold on. I'm not going to solve both your problems. It's only fair. I'll leave it to you to decide. Either I'll forgive Reno his debts, or I'll stake you in your fight for the little girl's heart. You Torons, you've got stones, I'll give you that.
You're making racial comments, sir?
No more than you're making a threat. Let's be clear. I don't like your boss. I don't like your planet, and I don't like your people. So you crawl under that rock where your Guatro lives, and you tell him that not only will I not be pressured or blackmailed, but the government of Caprica is going to take a very special interest in him, his business, and his low-life lawyers.
Perhaps you should think about it.
Deliver the message, Aaron boy. Word for word. The whole world in a glass. So many subtleties.
It's been a long time since you paid attention to any of my subtleties.
Waste of energy paying attention to something that isn't there. That's one of my favorite things about you, dear. You're clear as crystal.
Elaine was telling me how you guys met. Passion, romance.
There was passion, all right, but there's not much romance in disciplinary hearings.
You fell in love? Gave up your practice to be together?
She was mad as a cat. One flat-out beautiful girl. Well, the college frowns on these things, and with the pregnancy, they decided to relieve me of my practice.
I'm everything you think I am. A crook, a thief, a thug. There's never been any accounting for any of it. It occurred to me that until that happens, there's one thing I can never be. I'm 66 years old. I don't know how many more kicks of the can I'm gonna have. It's time.
I knew what was going to happen at the Congress.
That's impossible. How could you know?
How I knew, and how I came to be the man I am today, is going to become clear to you.
What's that?
The culmination of my life's work. You and I have a lot more in common than you realize, Edward.
I don't understand.
You will. You will.